r/AskReddit. 911 dispatchers of Reddit. What are some of the dumbest calls you've gotten? Kind of relevant. Worked in the Coast Guard where one of my jobs was the same thing as a dispatcher with radios and phones and boats instead of cars to respond. One day someone called me to tell me their young daughter was just kidnapped. I asked them if the kidnapper was on a boat or near the water. They said no. The caller just didn't think it was a big enough issue to call 911. So they called the Coast Guard instead. I've been a dispatcher for about 7 years now in a medium-sized county in Florida. Every year on the 4th of July and New Year's we get calls about gunshots. Every single time the caller is perfectly convinced they're gunshots and couldn't possibly be fireworks. They'll say they hear automatic weapons, or my personal favorite rapid-fire shotguns. And every single time a deputy goes out to investigate, it turns out to be the unlikely culprit of fireworks. I had one woman call 911 to tell me she found a cell phone on the ground. That's it. Irate elderly male calls 911 while standing in the sheriff's office lobby to report the clerk not being helpful. When I told him that's not something you use a 911 line for, he went apeshit, going as far as threatening to break into the office and shoot me. He was subsequently arrested. Male was arrested for domestic battery, called 911 from the backseat of the patrol car and stated he was being unlawfully imprisoned. When I told him the only thing I could do for him was to send him more deputies, he said, no thanks, and hung up. He then proceeded to call 3 more times looking for a different answer. We told the deputies on scene. They took his phone away and added a charge of misuse of 911. Had a woman call in stating she accidentally took too much melatonin. She started getting hysterical when she felt the effects of her overdose. She was getting sleepy. Yesterday morning was a cold one in my area. Icy conditions on the roads. Widespread crashes. All the good stuff. Lady calls in and complains about a suspicious substance on the road that made her car slip. She was driving too fast to see what it was but insisted that something strange was afoot. I had a lady call for a suspicious box she saw. She said she couldn't get a good description of it because she was driving by so fast. It was a speed trap. 2-minute account. If I had to pick a favorite, I'd have to choose the time a concerned citizen called in an animal stuck in a tree. That animal was a bird. Middle of night shift. Get a report of a guy trying to ride on a moose. Officer attends. There is indeed a male trying to ride said moose. Male is wearing a high vis vest and a helmet, which his girlfriend made him put on. For safety reasons, of course. A lady ran over herself with her own car. She called to let us know she was okay. This was fall of 2012. Hope she's up, still doing okay. Edit. Damn. That blew up. For those wondering, this was in CA. The lady was calm, laughed nervously, embarrassed a couple times, absolutely refused any type of response, even quiet from the FD, and didn't say how it happened. We took down her info, gave the typical safety admonishment, told her to call back if she needed to. Once my dad got a call from the 911 dispatch. At first he was really confused because he didn't call them in the first place. They asked, "So do you have a daughter?" "Yes." "Why?" "Well, she just called and claimed you broke her heart. Apparently my sister got in trouble when she was about 5 or 6 and called 911 claiming my daddy broke my heart." She hung up in embarrassment after the dispatcher began laughing. Every Thanksgiving you'll always get the person who calls because they don't know how long to cook a turkey. Never fails. Every Thanksgiving someone always puts a frozen turkey in a deep fryer, usually in a trailer home, and a fire surprisingly occurs. People who have warrants on themselves love calling to complain and ask to see the police in person for a dispute. They don't seem to remember we look up everyone in the dispute, not just the accused. We have a call that every new trainee at my county listens to during training, because it highlights how completely oblivious our callers can truly be. A neighbor enters her friend's house because she's not answering the door. She finds the patient on the couch sleeping. She calls 911 because she's not waking up. She says she's not moving, not answering me or waking up. It looks like she has been cooking with blueberries. Her hands are all blue. Operator already knows that means she's dead. We send everyone out. EMS arrives on scene first and immediately backs out. According to the deputy that arrived right after, she had a gun in hand. shot herself in the head and it splattered all over the wall behind her. Our caller never even noticed. Got a call from a woman in the wee hours of the morning, clearly drunk and slurring. She says, "I want you to send an ossifer to my house and tack me to the bar. Wait while I get drunk, and then tack me home. Me, mom, I think you are looking for a taxi service." Her, "Well, you guys suspended my license." Time passes. Her, "Okay, I'm ready. Come and get me." Me, "Mom, I already told you, we are not a taxi." Her, "I got warrants." Me, "Oh, well, in that case, they said she fought like a prize fighter." "I'm super drunk and I got run over by a sled. Now in northern Alberta typically this would mean a snowmobile and potentially life-threatening injuries. No, no, his kid hit his ankle bone with a wooden toboggan. Didn't even have a bruise." Around 3 a.m. Me, "County 911. Do you need police, fire, or medical?" Caller, "Nope. I'm calling to report there is no emergency." Me, "Okay. You don't need any assistance?" Caller, "No sir. Everything is good here." Me, "Okay. Well, you called an emergency." Caller, click. "Well, I guess I'll go duck myself then. Thanks, bud." "I'm not a 911 dispatcher, but I'm a central station operator. I'm the lady that asks what your password is when your alarm goes off. Been at my job 5 years. My favorite call ever was the second call I made to the house of an old couple. Their alarm had gone off about 30 minutes prior. They weren't sure why the alarm was sounding, so they asked me for the police to be dispatched. On the second call, the wife answered the phone, gave me all the correct information, and then passed the phone to the officer. The alarm was still sounding, but there was another weird beep in the background. We walked the owners through shutting their system off, but this beep was still going off. The officer was getting frustrated and the homeowners weren't sure why the alarm was still sounding, so they wanted me to shut the alarm down. I told him that our system was shut off and the beeping wasn't from us. The officer then went looking for the sound. He found out it was their alarm clock sounding. I swear I heard him roll his eyes through the phone and I tried my best not to laugh. He handed the phone back to the older couple, who still had no idea what was going on but said the officer told them everything was okay. TLDR. Old couple has us dispatch PD because of strange beeping noise. Officer arrives to find out it was their alarm clock. My mom was a dispatcher in Arizona after college back in the 70s, and told me a great story about a call she got, or rather a series of calls from an Indian man. Indian, not Native American. I can't recall what the original distress call was about, but after that first call, he started calling back all the time because he thought she had a sexy voice. She told me he would turn the charm level up to 11, trying to woo her in his thick Indian accent. Apparently, as soon as she would answer the call, his opening line was, "Hello, control. I loo over you," and she'd have to hold back her laughter. Edit. Talked to mom this morning and posted this as a reply below, but I'll paste it here too. Okay, so I talked to her this morning. My recollection was close enough, and she did give me one more story. More twisted, differently funny. So she gets a call from a payphone. Guy is slurring his words, but she makes out something that sounds like, "I cut off my pee." So to be safe, she sends out an ambulance to the location of the payphone and relays what she thinks happened. When they arrive on scene, EMT picks up the phone, still off the hook, and tells her that yes, the dude is sitting in a pile of blood with his cock in hand, separated from his body. EMT just says yep, he cut it off, and ends the call to tend to the man's self-inflicted wounds. Turns out he was a depressed veteran who wanted to be a woman, and took matters into his own hands. Some lady wanted the fire department to come burn her house down because she thought a demon lived in it. I sent paramedics and police to check on her, but I told her we'd be happy to burn her house down in a controlled training capacity if she wanted to donate it. But there was a lot of paperwork to get that started. I suspect her neighbors may have issues with this plan. Also, I would gladly open a beer and watch my neighbor's house burn down, as long as it got the demon out, of course. Me. 911, what's your emergency? Caller. There is a horse laying down in a field. Me. Do you believe it is injured? Caller. No, it just normally stands up. Me. Yeah, we will have a deputy go look at it. And yes, the horse was okay. So I am not a dispatcher, but I was a witness to this call while in high school. But the rifles are dummy, weighted, realistic looking rifles that can't fire and could only be used as a club. The drill team was practicing after school and after one guy missed the catch after throwing his rifle in the air, it came down and knocked him unconscious with a gash on his head. Spoiler. Look nasty but not life threatening. The teacher, a former Navy officer, immediately started first aid and told a student to call 911. Cell phones weren't as prevalent then and the kid went inside the building to use the phone. Now this is the dumb part. The student, panicking, told the 911 operator that his friend was a, hit by a rifle, b, at a high school, and was c, bleeding out. SWAT got there in about 7 minutes, sees a bunch of kids holding what appear to be rifles. Yeah, it was a cluster duck. One ambulance, out of 10 cent, got there eventually after SWAT gave the all clear. The kid hit by the rifle was okay but needed around 10 stitches and ended up with a new nickname of Snipe. Ducking, like and subscribe.